In this series of graphs, we're going to look at the pressure volume loops of the left and right ventricles in graphs A and B here. And what these are showing us is the view of cardiac events from the ventricle, essentially looking at the changes in volume and the changes of pressure that occur throughout a cardiac cycle. And that's important because the ventricles are the pumps that are driving blood through our systemic and pulmonary circuits. We're going to focus largely on the left ventricle over here in A. Now, what we're plotting here is left ventricular pressure versus left ventricular volume. And we have to sort of pick a spot here to start, right? Because it's forming a loop, and we travel around this loop counterclockwise over time. And so we can sort of jump in anywhere in a particular cardiac cycle. So let's jump in here. Right here, the AV valve would open. And the AV valve opens when ventricular pressure falls lower than atrial pressure. As soon as that occurs, the AV valve opens and we would begin to passively fill the ventricle, right? The blood is flowing from the veins through the atria, straight through the AV valve and into the ventricles. And a significant portion of our ventricular filling is passive. Now, note that we are starting at a volume above zero. We have an end-systolic volume. That's the blood left over from the previous ejection cycle. It's not zero. And we're going to fill passively and then actively all the way up to our end-diastolic volume. Our end-diastolic volume is the maximum volume that that ventricle has in this particular cycle, the volume that it's going to start with, pressurize, and then eject a portion of. Now notice at the end of this phase, we begin active filling. That's filling aided by the contraction of the atria. And so our atria are contracting, we're squeezing blood in here, our pressure's gonna start to rise a little bit here, but that's because the ventricles are becoming full. This left ventricle specifically is becoming full and the wall tension starts to rise a little bit. Notice as the ventricles are stimulated to contract, our AV valve would almost immediately close. We get our first heart sound. And we don't immediately begin to eject blood, right? We have to have this isovolumic phase where pressure is rising very rapidly, but we're not moving it yet because the pressure on the other side of the semilunar valve, in the aorta in this case, is still higher. And so our ventricle has to develop that pressure until it exceeds the pressure in the aorta and our semilunar valve will open. That means we're going to start ejecting blood, and we're going to start to go to the left here again, right? Remember, ventricular volume on our x-axis. So as we go left, our volume is falling, and we are ejecting that blood into the arterial circuit. Pressure continues to rise as that ventricle contracts. We reach a peak systolic pressure. Then that's going to start to fall, right? As the ventricle starts to relax, the pressure is going to fall in that ventricle. Now, blood continues to move out into the aorta, largely due to inertia for a very short period, but then ventricular pressure will fall below arterial pressure, and that aortic blood would tend to flow backwards into the ventricle for just a split second. Well, that's not really allowed because there's a valve there. There's a door that will slam shut immediately. That semilunar valve will close. We get our second heart sound there. And we once again become isovolumic, right? Vertical lines here, there's no change in volume. But pressure is rapidly falling as the ventricle relaxes to the point at which it falls below the atrial pressure again. And that AV valve will open once again, and we begin to fill passively, and then of course actively when the atria contract again. Now there's a whole variety of other information we can see from here besides just those events of the cardiac cycle. Our end-diastolic volume minus our end-systolic volume, our full volume minus our lowest volume, equals the stroke volume, right? That's a measure of cardiac performance. How much blood are we moving per contraction cycle? Additionally, we can see the our systolic pressure, as we noted, right? Our peak systolic pressure, that's the ventricular pressure and the aortic pressure are going to match up right there. Now, right before the semilunar valve opened would be the lowest point in our aortic pressure. And so that would be our diastolic pressure, right? So that one would be down here. The difference is the pulse pressure, as noted right here, right? The pressure difference between systolic and diastolic pressure. Another thing to point out is that work in fluid dynamics is equal to pressure times volume. And so the area of our trace is proportional to the amount of work being done by the ventricle. It's also proportional to the amount of oxygen being consumed, right, through the aerobic respiration of these cardiomyocytes to generate ATP and generate that contraction. And so the shape and size of this curve, right, this area of this loop, is proportional to the oxygen consumed and the work done, and we can actually relate it to the efficiency. How much work is being done per O2 consumed, per ATP, if you will. And so it tells us a whole lot about ventricular performance. And we'll also note that the shape of this loop will change over time based upon changes to particular cardiovascular components. Now, lastly, we want to look over here at the right ventricular pressure volume loop and note that it has some of the very similar characteristics. The stroke volume has to be the same, first of all. The output of the two sides of the heart have to be equal. These circuits feed one another. We go around this loop in the same fashion. There are isovolumic phases where the lines are vertical. But the big difference we see is the height, right? The ventricular pressure generated in the right is dramatically less than it is on the left. This is true due to a much reduced resistance to blood flow in the pulmonary circuit relative to the systemic circuit.